most drugs by themselves don't work as well as with combinations. In addition to steroids, we usually use three drugs all at once. And as we are able, we decrease the dose and we do take them off once we can. But steroids make all the other drugs work better.
Insomnia is a common side effect of steroid therapy. It can cause you to become more anxious or more hyperactive, and many people have trouble sleeping at night. So what we suggest is that you take steroids in the morning with breakfast. This way the steroids have a way of working themselves out towards the end of the day. So that's a real common fear of patients going on a steroid-based regimen. So we say that they probably will have an increase in appetite. So what we recommend is follow a diet, a moderate diet. And if they do need a snack and they do get hungry, that we encourage low-calorie snacks, some fruits, some vegetables, in order to prevent weight gain. Steroids have a lot of side effects, and some being psychological side effects. People can become more anxious, they can be more hyperactive. You're not going to have personality changes per se, but you may feel that some of your underlying personality traits may become a little stronger. For mild changes, you can try, you know, moderate exercise, you can try yoga, just relaxation techniques. If you feel anxious about all these changes, we have wonderful social workers at NewYork-Presbyterian Cornell Medical Center that sometimes just speaking to somebody can really help. One of the most common is GERD-like or reflux type problems where people may have a little burning or a little acid reflux. So for that, we prophylax everybody with a proteasome pump inhibitor. There are many out there, many are over the counter. Constipation is also an issue with steroids, so we recommend that if people have trouble with constipation, there's many different dietary interventions or over-the-counter medications in order to keep their bowels regular.
I think we definitely treat each patient uniquely, and the reaction that each patient's going to have is unique. I think it's important for both the patient and the physician to always be prepared. And so before we start any new drug, including steroids, we'll review the common toxicities because those are the ones you expect, but also to have the patient be comfortable to call with any new development.
Patients don't have to be on full dose steroids all the time during their treatment. In fact, we more often use the steroids at the initial stages of any treatment line. We understand that the use of corticosteroids long-term can accumulate more side effects. So we always try to dose reduce as the response of the treatment is more evident. In general, we try to limit the use of steroids long-term.